With Intel's Alder Lake processors and the top-of-the-range Z690 chipset having been on the market since November of 2021, it's high time that Intel's mid-range chipset offerings make their debut on the market. Enter the B660 chipset, a budget-friendlier way to get in on the Alder Lake bandwagon. For today's video, we'll be taking a look at the ROG STRIX B660-G gaming Wi-Fi from ASUS, representing the higher end on the spectrum for a board with the B660 chipset. This will be one of the many B660 boards in the micro ATX form factor that will be hitting the market over the next couple of days. Before we begin, big thanks to my friends over at Mansa Computers who have lent me this board for this video. Do check them out if you are on the lookout for a custom built PC solution in Singapore. With that, let's get started with the packaging and features of this board. Being from the Republic of Gamers lineup, the packaging sports a more premium looking design that hints at the board's position as a more performance oriented offering with a black and red color scheme. Moving over to the rear of the box, some features worth mentioning include a 12+1 power delivery solution, DDR5 support, PCIe 5.0 support, dual PCIe 4.0 M.2 slots, Intel 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet and Wi-Fi 6 built-in. And this is rounded up by a premium audio solution powered by the Supreme FX S1220A audio codec. Onto the contents of the box. We see that ASUS has included a Wi-Fi antenna with a built-in magnetic base that will allow you to secure it to the case of your PC. Setting aside the board for the moment, we see that ASUS has included quite a fair bit of kit with the board, starting with two sets of SATA 3 cables, a spare M2 Q-latch attachment. Now this board comes with the Q-latch feature that allows you to install a M2 drive via a toolless design. They've also included a M2 drive pad, which is to be used to add additional height clearance for you folks out there with single-sided M2 SSDs. And this is accompanied by some cable ties. Also included is the usual slew of manuals and guides, a DVD driver disc, and we also do get an Armory Crate leaflet accompanied by a sheet of stickers. The game to end all games. Fancy. Now, in case you've just got to flex the fact that you have a ROG motherboard, ASUS has got you covered with a ROG keychain that looks pretty nice in my opinion. With that, let's get on to the board itself. Presenting the B660G Gaming Wi-Fi. As we can see, the black PCB is littered with ROG motifs throughout and sports large VRM heatsinks that melt nicely with the integrated I/O shield design. Power delivery, according to ASUS, is in the 12+1 configuration with 5K black metallic capacitors, as I quote from the motherboard manual. I'm really digging the subtle design nuances of this board, which I suppose is to be expected seeing as this is a ROG board after all. Even the heatsink has a Pac-Man-esque ghost motif, which in my opinion adds character to the board's overall appearance. In the memory department, the B660G comes with 4 DDR5 slots in a single tab design with support for up to 128GB of RAM and the DDR5 6000 standard. Right next to the RAM slots are debug LEDs that allow you to troubleshoot boot issues. Moving further down is a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C front panel header, and this is accompanied by a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header. For storage, the board comes with 4 SATA 3 ports, and this is accompanied by 2 M.2 slots that support the PCIe 4.0 X4 standard. Now the 2 M.2 slots are located beneath these heatsinks here and here. Boasting support for the latest PCIe 5.0 standard, the B660G comes with a single PCIe 5.0 X16 slot with the ASUS Safe Slot feature, which reinforces the slot especially if you have a heavy graphics card installed. It also comes with 2 PCIe 4.0 X1 slots and a single PCIe 3.0 X16 slot operating in X4 mode. Audio for this board is powered by the SupremeFX S1220A audio codec, which is hidden beneath this shield, and this is accompanied by a Savitech SV3H712 amplifier chip. Internet connectivity-wise, the board has 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, courtesy of Intel's I225V, and this is rounded off with Wi-Fi connectivity provided by Intel's AX201 Wi-Fi 6 solution. Onboard fan connectors are a little on the low side, with 4 headers located in these areas of the board. ASUS has also included 3 addressable RGB headers and a single 12V RGB header, and they are located in these corresponding areas. Now do note that the board does not come with built-in Thunderbolt 4 ports, and makes do with a Thunderbolt header here that allows you to hook up a Thunderbolt 4 add-on card that is sold separately by ASUS. Moving over to the rear I/O connectors, the B660G comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 connector, a HDMI 2.1 port, a BIOS flashback button that allows you to update the BIOS without needing to install a CPU or RAM, 4 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A port, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 X2 Type-C port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, the usual array of audio jack connectors, and a single USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C port. To conclude, the ASUS ROG STRIX B660-G Gaming Wi-Fi is a solid option from ASUS for someone looking to purchase a higher-end B660 board for Alder Lake, with features such as 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, built-in Wi-Fi 6, more premium built-in audio, and to top it off, it's a great looking board as well. Pricing-wise, do note that with DDR5 prices and availability being big issues as of early January 2022, you might need to set aside additional budget to stomach the costs of jumping onto the DDR5 bandwagon if you were to consider using this board as part of your PC build. That aside, I do wish, however, that ASUS had included more fan headers with this board and more USB 3.2 ports on the rear I/O. After all, 4 USB 2.0 ports on the rear does seem rather dated in today's context. With that, thank you so much for watching. Do like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys around the next time.